many lengths, Ma?
12.
It'd be awesome to have my own pool in London.
I always used to count the lengths you swam in Guernsey, do you remember?
Yeah. I'm using the one at Grey Gables.
Oh, Ian swims there before work.
I know. I've seen him.
What time do you have to leave?
Oh, well, I'll need to hit the road by 5:30, really.
Oh, so I've still got you for 3 whole hours.
Yeah. Oh, it's going to be hard to drag myself away from all this.
Oh. Have your drink, darling.
Just let me spread this towel out. Oh, I caught sight of Brenda this morning.
Oh, dear. Yeah,
not to speak to.
She and Tom are engaged.
Are they now?
Sorry, I've had so much to think about, I forgot to tell you.
Let me lie down. So, she's practically family.
Afraid so.
Hope they don't invite me to the wedding. That drink's perfect, thanks. Do you think she knew anything about Matt and Stephen's business?
Well, she did. She was too thick to understand its significance. There's been no peep from him all week.
No.
Well, at least I've had you here for comfort, darling.
I'm sorry I can't stay the weekend, Ma.
Oh, you've got your own life to lead. I keep trying to think myself inside his head.
Why?
To help me understand what he's feeling.
And what is he feeling?
Well, that the whole world's against him. His creditors are baying for blood. The board stabbed him in the back. And his ex-employees all blame him. When Stephen was the real culprit.
It takes two to tango.
Do you know, he even had some woman drag her child to the Dower House because her husband couldn't find himself another job after leaving C3PL. It's ludicrous. But he's not been found guilty of anything yet.
Do you know when the trial's likely to be?
Oh, it's months away.
Tricky.
It's more than tricky, James.
Ma, you won't... Are you going to have him back if he goes to prison?
Well, I don't even know if he'll want me. James, I can hardly bring myself to think about it.
Can you pass me staple gun? Under the plastic.
Yes, here it is. Anyway, I've really got to get on with it and get my transport organised. It'll be all too easy to take advantage of Alistair. But a car shouldn't merely transport one from A to B. It should define one. Don't you think so, Joe?
Like me and me trap.
Precisely.
Or Jack Woolley and his Bentley,
If I were defined by the cars I've seen this week, people would conclude I was bland and soulless.
What about this yellow sports car?
Yes, I'm taken with that.
It could be a widow magnet.
Well, I hope I never close the door to that possibility.
Nor me. Can you put your sewing down a minute, Prof, and give me a hand?
Oh, gladly. What can I do?
You just hold the trellis steady on the table while I staples this plastic to it, eh?
I've got it.
I need to finish this before Clarity comes home from work. It's secret, see?
What about Eddie?
Oh, he's at home farm till late. That's where I got all this heavy-duty plastic. But I don't want him and Clarity gossiping. And I don't want no one stealing my idea.
Well, my lips are sealed.
Do you swear?
Solemn.
Yeah, especially I don't want Bert Fry getting wind. That plinth prize has got my name on it. There.
You're very competitive, aren't you?
Oh, well, he deserves to win on grounds of aesthetic merit and originality. This'll be right up that Anthony Gormley Street.
I hope you're right, Joe.
Oh, I am. I studied him on the computer in the bull, you see. Oh, he won't be interested in Bert Fry staring into space. Here we are.
Excellent.
And if he's judging as well as opening the fate, he might donate a piece of his own work. You never know.
So that's your motivation.
Yeah, I could sell it on the internet for thousands. It could supplement me pension for the rest of me days.
Well, your handiwork's certainly more impressive than mine.
Well, that's because you're an intellectual, you see. Old brains are no application.
All right. I'm not making much headway with this hem.
Put it on and I'll check it for length, if you like.
Oh, thank you.
Well, you helped me with my costume. Now, mind the pins now. It's a neat trick, turning a duvet cover into a toga.
Yes, I was rather pleased with myself.
Yeah. Ah, no, no. That is a bit uneven down there, you see?
Oh, dash it.
Going uphill towards your left knee.
Alistair's mother was a demon with a needle.
Yeah, and you'll want the shoulder gathering so it looks more Roman-like. Hmm?
I thought the same. Oh, yeah. I'll give it to Shula. She can do it before Sunday.
Ah. So, what's this Latin speech you've got up your sleeves in?
Cato. He wrote a famous book on agriculture in 150 BC.
He never.
The section I'm quoting is on the virtue of cabbage as a medicine. De Brassica.
Brassica? What a coincidence. That's what I course my cabbages.
It covers broccoli as well.
Yeah, well, I'm sure the gardeners in the village will find it fascinating. What with flowers, even Latin names and all. And I think we've earned a second fairy cake.
Oh, goody.
Help yourself.
Ah, thank you, Joe. Yeah. It's really nothing like homemade.
Oh, no, I think we'd best put the lid on the tin in case Clary notices they're gone.
Oh.
Mm. They're strictly for the fate, you see.
Ah, and they taste all the sweeter for that. Careful, Joe. You're leaving evidence.
Eh?
Hundreds and thousands on the table by your elbow.
Oh, yeah.
I see you've been invited to this wedding.
Eh?
The invitation on your mantelpiece there.
Oh,
I met the delicious Vicky last Sunday.
Oh, the daughter's taken it bad, Clary says.
Vicky's?
Mike's.
Oh, pity.
Now, her mother was a saint. Go, dude, look at the time.
Do you want me to go?
Oh, no. They're doing a piece from Lower Loxley on Radio Porsche, sure. You almost forgot.
How interesting.
All a bit of
so, of course, Lizzie was then absolutely thrilled when he rang her up.
Yeah, that's Nigel Pardew, too.
My personal offering for the Ambridge plinth is, well, to dress up in my father's old blazer and boater and bat away wet sponges with a tennis racket.
Daft
idea. 50p for three sponges. So come along and see if you can hit me.
Oh, I'm bound to win.
That was good, Nigel.
I think Lizzie came across better than me.
When did they record it?
Oh, this morning in the crack barn.
All right. Well, well done to you both. OK, shall we get back to building the plinth?
Sure.
I could have done without this, really.
I bet.
Felt like crashing out once I'd unloaded the heifers.
Well, you must be tired. What with all your comings and goings this week?
Yeah. Well, Dad and I left the show straight after lunch to get ahead of the traffic.
Very wise.
But we both felt kind of sad, you know, pulling away from the showground.
I'm sure.
Right, now, this set of steps will take them up onto the trailer.
Yep.
You just shove them in a bit.
Okay. There.
Poor old Dad looked tired when I dropped him off at home as well. Still, I promised Linda that I'd bring the trailer and bales to the green before supper.
Are we meant to be pinning the bunting round it as well?
No, I think Linda's doing that tomorrow. We can check with Alan. He's got a list of instructions.
She and Lizzie have become quite pally through all this, you know.
Right. Let's start on the planks.
OK. Are they going lengthways across the bales?
Yeah. You get up on the trailer and I'll pass them up.
Right you are. Still, it's got me and Lizzie involved.
Yeah. There you go. Numero uno.
I got it.
I hadn't realised that you were bringing your Shire horse down for the fete.
Cranford Crystal. It was Toby's idea.
That'll be great.
And I'm helping Neil demonstrate the mobile belfry.
Ah.
Though we won't have much time to practice it, unfortunately.
Right. Here's the next one.
Got it. But the rig's only coming Sunday morning.
Uh-huh.
Ah. Neil says the belfry will feel a lot lighter than the ones in the church.
Hey, make sure that there are no gaps, won't you?
Okay. At least the weather looks set fair for Sunday.
Yes, and tomorrow for the cricket.
Jim and Joe are coming across the green.
Is that a secret?
Well, poor Alistair was treating one of our tamworths this morning. Jim's running him and Shula ragged.
I can believe it. Hello, Joe. Hi, Jim.
Afternoon.
Hello there.
Hardly Trafalgar Square, is it?
No, but the straw bales will lend a certain rural charm to Cato's words.
Cato? Crikey, that takes me back to the Lower Fifth.
Knew a lot about veg.
Brassica est quae omnibus oleibus antistat.
Good lord.
Eum esto vel cockdam vel crudam.
Then you keep your powder dry, Bob. Let's have a go on it proper, shall we?
Hey, no, you don't. It's nowhere near finished, yeah?
Well, how are we supposed to get the measure of it, then?
Well, you'll have to wait till Sunday.
Sunday?
Linda doesn't want anyone climbing up here before she's satisfied it's completely safe.
Yeah. I'm wandering over to the stables now, Joe, to see if Shula can transform this sorry effort into a toga fit for an orator.
Ah, would you, Aaron?
I enjoyed our craft afternoon.
Me and all. And remember...
Mum's the word.
Hey, Joe. Hey. What is it that you're actually doing up here on Sunday?
Yes, there are all kinds of rumours flying around.
Is it right that it involves alcohol?
You can wait and see. But I anticipate winning with flying colours.
Oh, James.
Oh, steady, Ma. You'll squeeze the life out of me.
Oh, I wish you didn't have to go back.
I know.
Why not stay for supper? Jenny, you'd be more than happy.
No, I've got to go. I'm schmoozing this new client tonight, and the traffic's always grim on a Friday.
Oh, all right. Oh, I've so enjoyed our outings, darling.
Me too. I can't bear to think of you hiding away, Ma. Promise me you won't let Matt rob you of all your sparkle and fizz, your lemon zest.
Oh, I do feel like a flat G&T these days.
And there's nothing sadder, except flat champagne.
James, you do cheer me up. Go on, quickly now, or I shan't let you go at all.
Righto. I'll phone.
Drive safely, darling. Oh, my baby.
Right.
James!
Right, now you listen to me.
Oh, I like that, is it?
You've made my mother's life a misery.
Oh, here we go.
You nearly damn well killed her.
Oh, now it's about our money, are you? Go get lost.
Don't you...
Oi!
I've got three things to say to you. One, I hope you're sent to prison for a very long time.
Just get out of here.
Two, you can leave my mother alone. And three, do everyone a favour, Matt. Just clear off out of Ambridge...